Hi, I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. This video is a review of the plugin Soothe 2, which has just been released by OX Sound. The plugin is described as a dynamic resonance suppressor or a dynamic EQ which automatically reduces nasty frequencies. Soothe 2 offers an automated way of handling problematic frequencies, like with voice. It can handle harshness and reduce boominess and proximity effect easily too. Let's check out the plugin controls. So Soothe is a plugin which reduces resonances and peaks, etc. And you have a few controls which you can set how it reacts to the audio. Here's the main section where you set how and how much it reduces. This is the EQ section where you set where it reduces. If you go back to the main section, you will find depth, sharpness and selectivity. Depth will set the amount of reduction. If you increase it, it will cut more. If you decrease it, it will cut less. Sharpness over here sets the width or Q of every cut it makes. So decrease will make the cuts smaller and increase will make the cuts wider. With selectivity, you will select if it will focus more on a general shape of the audio or focus more on individual frequencies. The soft and hard button is what you expect. Soft is more gentle in its reduction and hard is more aggressive when you really need to dig in some peaky frequencies. On the bottom, you will find the stereo mode settings. Soothe can work in standard left-right stereo and also in mid-side stereo. The link sets how much both channels are linked together. With link set to zero, Soothe 2 works like a dual mono processor. And with the balance button, you can set if Soothe works more on the left or the right side, or in mid-side mode, more on the mids or more on the side. The EQ section works like an inverted EQ. The band sets where Soothe 2 does its work. Increasing the band will make Soothe 2 do more reduction, and decreasing it will make Soothe 2 do less of its work. You have several types of bands, like high pass with 6 dB, 12, 24 or 84 dB slopes, bell type bands, which can be set to low shelf, band shelf, high shelf, band reject, and tilt EQ. So these all set the way Soothe works. Before we continue, let's use an example to show the resonance reduction capabilities of Soothe 2. Here's a part of the track The Tales of Things to Sink by French black metal band Ifernay. I did a vinyl mastering for them and I will put the link to that in the description below. This is the unmastered track and is used with permission, of course. Let's play a bit. Often with electric guitars, you will have resonances which will cloak other frequencies. It can happen you don't even notice this at first hand. Let me show in FabFilter 3 where these frequencies are in this track. So now you cannot unhear these frequencies anymore. Let's use Soothe 2 now. First I set the frequency area. It was around 3300 Hz. And I increased the EQ to let Soothe work more in this area. I will set a high pass and a low pass to have Soothe only working in this area and not affect the low band and high band. Let's see how it sounds. and soothe off. It really does its job. Okay, let's go over some more controls in Soothe 2. You can set in this section the attack and release. This will determine how quickly Soothe reacts to the material, and increasing the attack will leave transients and attacks of, for instance, snare drum untouched. Let's tweak those a bit. Let's increase the sharpness for now. As you tweak the attack and release, you can really change how much of the resonance will be reduced and when it comes back. Let's go to the quality section. You have oversample, resolution, real-time and offline. Oversample makes the computer distinguish individual resonances better. It will cost more CPU if you increase it, but it will make, for instance, with bass frequencies, that it can determine the bass frequencies a little bit better, so it sounds a bit smoother. If you change the resolution, it's mostly useful for high transient materials. It will leave that more intact. And then you have real-time and offline. Real-time is, of course, what happens when you work in a mix, and offline when you bounce it. So you can, while mixing, you can do, for instance, lower the oversampling and resolution. And when you bounce, you set them to the max settings to have the best resolution. It's pretty handy if you need to save CPU. First off, let's go over here, the output. You have mix and trim, delta and bypass. Mix is a dry wet control, so that determines how much of the original signal and the treated signal are blended together. Trim changes the volume of the wet signal only. So, it's only for the wet signal. And then on the bottom you have a delta and a bypass button. The bypass button is a soft bypass button and leaves all the processing happening in the background, only it's not active. It works a little bit different than the standard bypass button of a plugin, which disables the entire plugin. And on some computers you will have a drop in audio when you use that one. I don't have it, but it happens. Delta is actually sort of a listen button. So, there you can hear exactly what Soothe is reducing. There's only the reduced signal is in the delta button. Okay, let's go to the side change section. And for that, I will change the example from Ivernay to Cannibalistic Squirrel. Here's a part of the drums of Verkoopmannetje. What I will do is I will use Soothe 2 as a sidechain for the overheads. First I need to set the sidechain. Snare. Activated. It's activated already. That's good. Let me listen to the overheads. Now we'll check if the sidechain is happening. Sidechain is happening. And let's now tweak it. As you can see, here's a little bit happening, but it's way too less. So let's boost the frequency over here. The way the sidechain works is it takes the frequencies of the snare drum and reduces the overheads on those exact frequencies. Let's bypass it. This is a really good way to reduce the snare drum in the overheads. So if you're going for that really close mic sound, this is one way to do it. Let's use a Soothe without sidechain on just the overheads, just to see if there are some frequencies happening and reduce them a bit. There you have it, Soothe 2. In my opinion, this is a really useful plugin. I see its uses on almost everything in the mix, like overheads, drums, bass, guitar, vocals. I see its uses in broadcast, when you have these little lavalier mics and people go like this and have all these resonances in their voice because of that. It's really easy to overuse, so be careful with that one, because it's so soothing. I will definitely use it in my mixes. Thank you for watching. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye!